big difference now. You can see everything looks a lot nice, a lot drier, a lot nicer, a lot drier. The pits is nice and dry. So these drivers are going to have a nice dry race here for the Spanish Grand Prix. I apologize that I've had a couple slip-ups with my my grammar and vocabulary so far here in the stream. It's been a couple of days since I've done a commentary, but hopefully by the end of the race, I'll have all of that sorted out for you. Again, welcome to the ASN PCL Round 5 Spanish Grand Prix. As we get these drivers set here on the formation lap. So, having qualified on the wet compound tires, now we'll have a look at the tires of these drivers ahead of the opening lap here. It looks like our two front row drivers are on the hard compound. Very, very interesting to see that. Xavi in P4, the only other driver to come in on those on those hard compound tires. Everybody else on the grid deciding to go for the medium compound tire. Obviously, the medium compound tire being a little bit quicker than the hard tire, but does not last as long, of course. So very interesting to see a difference in strategy at the front two rows of the grid. We'll see how those strategies play out here in the race. A couple things to be mindful of here in the race, of course. Codemasters updated the frequency of safety cars a couple of weeks back, so that will be one thing to look for, is safety cars. Strategy is definitely going to get changed if we see one of those. Of course, the VSC as well is a possibility. Damage is full, so if these drivers get into any scraps, it could be devastating. As these drivers now come across to line up on the grid. Now, obviously, turn one very crucial here for these drivers. Everyone wanting to keep things clean as the drivers get their engines going nice and revved up here. 2, 3, 4 lights now. 5 lights. And we're off. It's lights out here in Spain. Some idiot on pole leading the grid through down into turn one now. DS making a fast move into second there. Brownie now back into third. Everything clean so far from these drivers. Little bit of contact there. Looks like it might have been an end plate coming off of that Haas of travesty as we come up through turn two now. So far, so good. A couple of places lost, a couple of shuffles. Ooh, and there's a spin there. It looks like the Red Bull of Xavi is out in the back now. Not too sure what happened there. The Toro Rosso of JBS has had a spin as well. Not too happy about that is the Toro Rosso driver, I'm sure. Cali now moving up into P15. Some idiot still in the lead of this race. DS with a fast move on Brownie there, coming down into turn one. He's now up into P2. Brownie has fallen back a place. David in P4. Ooh! And there's a big crash there. It looks like the Red Bull of Skybits. Not sure what happened to Skybits there. We'll see if he's able to get that car back on the circuit there. Very, very interesting. Not too sure what happened to Skybits there, but we saw that. He went straight into that wall and lost a massive amount of that front wing. As we wait for Cody's to update my intervals, as these drivers now finish out the opening lap here in Barcelona. Some idiot crossing the line, 125.8, starting off the fastest lap battle. Down into turn one now. Spin from Flyer. Ooh, not good for the Ferrari driver there as his teammate moves ahead of him. He drops back all the way down into P11 as he tries to get back onto the circuit cleanly here. He's now dropped into 13th, and he loses it again. Those tires are going to be very, very hot. He's on the grass. He's going to have to take things easy here as he tries to get that car back onto the circuit safely. My intervals still having not updated entirely. Not too sure what's going on there. Hopefully Cody's is able to fix that for me shortly. It's because of all of these spins, I think. But DS is currently half a second behind our race leader in the Racing Point, some idiot in that McLaren. Brownie in P3, currently half a second behind the McLaren and the Williams. Well, Kaio's out of the race. Looks like he had a spin going through sector two. That's very unfortunate for the Racing Point. As these drivers now finish out the second lap here, very, very eventful as the Ferrari of Flyer is still struggling, I think, on those tires. JBS also having issues. Brownie now overtaking the McLaren down into turn one here. Is he able to make that move stick? The McLaren right behind him, very, very close, coming through turn two now. Turn three. Ooh, DS goes way wide there and keeps things under control as he gets things back onto the circuit. David looking to capitalize in the Renault behind him. Skybits now into the pits, has fallen back into 16th in that Red Bull. We'll see if he's able to make something happen here throughout the remainder of the race. Very unfortunate to see him at the back of the grid this early on, having started in P9. As I do now have updated intervals, we'll be able to pay closer attention to the battles going on the circuit. Currently, a couple notable fights going on are David fighting with the McLaren for P3. Very, very tight there on the gearbox of that McLaren coming up through into sector three. We'll see if he's able to stay on the McLaren through into the pit straight with DRS. Smasha looking for a battle here for P5 with Tech Slave, as well as Tesmo looking for that P8. MJ is looking at Tesmo as well here, coming through on lap three. Some idiot now crossing the line into lap four, setting. He is our race leader, but Brownie set the fastest lap. David making a move down through into turn one now. Keeps on the rear of that McLaren. Tesmo ahead of Travesty now. I do believe that Haas driver has front wing damage, and he does. He is missing his front right end plate. Definitely going to affect his pace here in the opening phase of the race. Tesmo now comfortably up into P8, it seems, as Travesty may make a move later on here in the lap. MJ's also looking to fight for some positions there, as he's very, very close to the rear of that Haas driver in the McLaren. David still very, very tight to the rear of that McLaren now, as we come through into sector three on the DRS straight. Is he going to make a move? Coming down the inside. Oh, he thinks better of it. Stays on the rear of that McLaren. Coming through this difficult sector three zone. We'll hope to see a move from him, I'm sure, down the pit straight. Couple of tight intervals forming further on down the grid as Xavi looking to make a move on Gelmel soon in that Renault. We'll see what happens there between those two drivers in a second. As it's the Renault now moving down the inside, coming down the pit straight into turn one. We'll see if he's able to make a move stick here. Ooh, swerves right in front of the McLaren driver there into turn one, causing some early braking. Doesn't look like either driver had contact there coming through turn two and three here. Again, couple drivers going very wide there through turn three. It looks like the McLaren trying to make a move. Ooh, and it's the McLaren of DS coming down through sector two now. Very, very tight on the rear here as we have Gelmel diving into the pits. Cali now up into P11. Not too sure what happened there. Still focused very much on this front of the grid fight between the Renault and McLaren driver of DS. The McLaren now has the ERS, a bit of a swerve, trying to lose the slipstream there from the Renault in front. Coming up in through sector three now. Looks like the McLaren might be able to stick on the rear of that Renault Flyer, taking a 3-second time penalty in that Ferrari after multiple warnings have been handed down from the stewards. Final turns now on lap five. We'll see if DS is able to stay in DRS range here, coming through down into the pit straight. It looks like he will have the DRS. What a difference the DRS makes when trying to stay on the rear of the driver in front of you. As we come down into turn one, are we going to see a fast move here? No. This is currently the battle to be watching on the grid, as we have some idiot currently leading the race, a second and 3/10 ahead of Brownie in that Williams. David in their Renault, 4 seconds behind P2, as there's a bit of, ooh, it's David out off wide into the dirt and grass. DS now moves up into P3, and Techslave takes a fast position away from the Renault driver. The Renault can't be too happy about that, as he will try to make back that position from Techslave here. Techslave seeming like he got some free real estate there. Smasha in the Ferrari up into P6, Bois in P7, Tesmo in P8, Travesty in P9, Zavi in P10, rounding off the top 10 drivers here. Wakayo in that Racing Point, as you can see, he's been grayed out as he is out of the session. I'm sure he won't be too impressed with that. Very unfortunate finish for the Racing Point there of Wakayo. Gelmel in P14. Now we'll take a look at the stops of these drivers. Gelmel and Skybits having been the only two drivers to pit so far here in the race. We're also going to take a look at the fastest lap. Currently the fastest lap is set by Brownie in the Williams running P2. It's a 121.7. Gap to leader from the back of the grid is only 53 seconds. Not too bad yet. Obviously still chances here in the race for a safety car. Sector 3 yellow flag comes up now. Going to jump back to some action here as Zavi very, very close to the rear here of Travesty. One thing to take note of that I was unfortunately unable to see was Techslave did drop back into P5. David now back into P4. He's looking for another fight with that McLaren soon. Doesn't look like any of those drivers have any damage at the moment. Very, very good for them here on lap 7. JBS now into the pits in the Toro Rosso. That's going to push up Skybits into P15. Zavi has the overtake on Travesty. Travesty will look to fight back now as Brownie comes across the line in the Williams with a 121.7. Smasha starting to get closer to that Alpha up in P6 and 5. The battle for P5 looks like it's going to happen very, very soon here. We'll jump on over to the Ferrari to take a look on how that's unfolding. JBS's car currently ghosted. Not too sure what happened there. He may have crashed out of the session due to some kind of technical problem. Not too sure if he'll be back or not. Smasha very close on the rear of the Alpha now. Coming through into Sector 2. We'll see if he's able to maintain that gap going into the DRS detection zone. I think he will. He's going to have DRS here, but of course... Ooh! What happened here with the McLaren? Looks like we had a spin from the McLaren driver. David now up into P3. Everybody's going to move up a couple of positions here. Hopefully he's able to get that under control quickly. Doesn't look like he's got any damage. As Tesmo now jumps ahead of the McLaren as well. Smasha still very close to the rear of that Alpha. He'll be looking to stick to him like glue. Brownie sets another fastest lap here. It's a 121.4. Looking very, very quick as he is flying on the hard compound tires. He's currently less than a second behind the race leader. These two race leaders have quite the gap separating them from the rest of the race. 10 seconds the gap between positions 2 and 3 at the moment, as Brownie is going to have DRS at some point here on lap 9. Currently less than a second separating him and the race leader of some idiot in that Racing Point. Smasha still on the rear of that Alpha. DS now very, very tight here on the rear of Tesmo. We'll go on board with him to see if he can make a move. Tesmo, not as much traction through this turn as DS. DS coming around the outside now. Ooh, a little bit of a wheel tap there from the McLaren driver. Very, very tight rounding that turn two wide, and it looks like the McLaren might have etched ahead of that Toro Rosso, but these drivers are keeping things neat and tidy, wheel to wheel. Looks like Xavi is off behind them. Ooh, and no, that's Tesmo in the Toro Rosso. Xavi sticking to the McLaren like glue now. He's going to look to make a move as he comes ahead of the McLaren down through into sector three. Very, very interesting drive here as the McLaren looks to come back. The Red Bull shuts the door. Very, very exciting action here between the McLaren, Red Bull, and Toro Rosso drivers. Travesty in P9 in that Haas is watching all of this unfold ahead of him. As we come down the pit straight now, we see Smasha going down into turn one. He's ahead of Tech Slave now. Is he able to make that move stick? Looks like he will. Xavi still ahead of the McLaren there, coming through the first couple turns here. We're now on lap 10 as we have another yellow flag there in sector three. It looks like the Red Bull of Skybits is off. Skybits not having the race he wanted to have today, unfortunately. Looks like he has more wing damage there, missing a front left end plate. Where is the safety car when you need it? I'm sure some of these drivers are thinking right now. Brownie's still very, very tight on the front of the grid. Keeping a very close eye on that racing point, not letting him get too far ahead. Keep in mind, both of these drivers are on the same tire strategy as well, so we could see a very, very intense battle here throughout the entirety of the race between these two. Definitely looking forward to that, as Tech Slave, currently less than half a second, separates him between P4. DS, the McLaren that we've been watching for most of the race, having very intense battles throughout this campaign. We'll see what he chooses to do here, as the pit window, I do believe, is now open for some of these drivers. Travesty coming into the pits now, looking to get off those mediums. Perhaps a wing change is in order. He'll move back a few places now. DS, as we come through in sector one now, he's looking to make up some time on the Red Bull driver in front of him. Tech Slave currently less than a second behind P4. Brownie currently less than a second behind P1 here in the race so far. And those are the most notable intervals that we can speak of, as MJ's goes into the pits in the McLaren. MJ's taking that 5 second speeding in the pit lane penalty. He's not going to be happy about that. David, very comfortable in P3 in the Renault now, as we are watching and on board with this McLaren coming down through this turn. He is making up a lot of time on the rear of that Red Bull now. Brownie into turn one. Not able to get quite ahead of that racing point just yet, but he is staying on him. Tech Slave looking to make a move here on the Ferrari, maybe down the pit straight. Ooh, coming down into turn one here. It's the Alfa out ahead of the Ferrari. Very nice overtake there. No damage, no contact. Very, very clean. Very, very risky as we come through turn three now. Very, very nice from the Alfa of Tech Slave here. Smash is going to be He's going to be looking to come back though, as there is another DRS straight coming up here for these two. Xavi, looks like he may have had an issue there. He's dropped back into 10th. Tesmo into 9th now. Still with Smasha here on the rear of the Alpha, coming through the DRS straight. He's making up some time. Is he going to make a move? Doesn't look like it. Ooh, he has to swerve out to the outside there. He goes off wide a little bit. Late braking from the Ferrari there, trying to catch the rear of Tech Slave coming through down into that turn. He's lost a ton of time there. And the teammate of Tech Slave, Bois, in P6, is now starting to apply the pressure. David in P3, now into the pits here. We'll see where he falls out. Techslave opting to pit as well. Will we see Smasha? Yes, we do. Smasha into the pits. Looks like Bois is going to pass all three of them as he comes down the pit straight into turn one. Jumping up into third in that alpha. We'll see how that pays off for him. DRS is now enabled. Did I miss something there? Did I miss a VSC? I feel like I may have missed a VSC or something because DRS should have been enabled 10 laps ago. But nevertheless, DRS is enabled now according to race control. David in P4. If only I had Martin Brundle next to me to highlight some of these things while I'm too busy talking about the race going on. Am I right, Mikel? Flyer in P5 in that Ferrari. Cali now up into P9 as there's a DNF from the McLaren driver in turn three. Very, very unfortunate for the McLaren there. Ooh, not too sure what we saw there from him, but DS is out of this race and JBS is out of this race as well. Ooh, not good for those two. Three DNFs here so far out of 17. That leaves us with 14 drivers remaining, of course. Hope you liked my quick math there. Brownie still just hanging on to some idiot, just keeping constant pressure, not even letting him breathe here. It's been 14 laps and these two have just not given each other an inch to work with. Brownie has been less than a second behind him for the whole of this race. Very, very impressive from these two out in the lead of the race. Bois in that alpha. Currently P3. We'll see if he decides to pit here soon. Currently running those mediums for 13 full laps so far. Flyer very, very close to the rear of David in that Renault. We'll see if the Ferrari is able to make up some time here. David on the fresh hards. Could still be struggling to get those tires hot. The Ferrari with DRS now in sector two, coming down through the turn into sector three, makes up a little bit of time, but not enough to make a move. Could be very possible. We see a move from Flyer here moving through into lap 16 on the pit straight, unless he opts to pit for new tires. I have to say, as the commentator, I am impressed that we have not seen a safety car as of yet, at the very least a full safety car. It's possible I missed a VSC earlier on. David passing Bois now as Bois is into the pits. David back into P3. Flyer very, very close on him moving through into turn one. Tech Slave into P5 now ahead of his teammate. Looks like Bois is going to come out in seventh there as Smasha 3.3 behind Tech Slave. He'll look to close the gap on the same tires as Tech Slave. Cali pits, Tesmo and Gel move up a position. Xavi comes across in the Red Bull with a 121.1, snatching that fastest lap in P11. Hopefully he'll be able to hang on to that. Flyer still very, very tight on the rear of the Renault here. Keep in mind, David on the two-lap old hard compound tires, where Flyer running 14 laps on the mediums. Could be starting to have issues with traction here in that Ferrari. And he decides to go into the pits here. David, the pressure is off of David for now. As he is 36 seconds behind P2 in that Renault. Brownie and some idiot not giving each other any room to maneuver here. Both stuck in P's 1 and 2. Looks like Brownie might make a move here to see if he can push that driver of some idiot into the pits. And there's a big slide out from the rear of that Williams, and he is spun. As he resets to track now, Ooh, he is not going to be happy about that. He has lost a massive amount of time to the racing point. We'll see if the racing point goes into the pits. He doesn't. I could only imagine Brownie will. And he doesn't. He decides to stay out. Not too sure what to say about that there. He has lost a massive chunk of time to some idiot there after the spin. Glad we caught that here on stream. That was huge for the P2 driver. Gel now in P10. Currently less than a second separating him and Tesmo in the Toro Rosso ahead of him. Very interesting to see what can be done here by the Renault driver coming through in lap 17. Looks like he's catching the Toro Rosso here. He has the DRS. Not too much wheel-to-wheel action going on the circuit at the moment. Gelmel looking to fight with Tesmo very, very soon. Travesty taking a 3-second time penalty for multiple warnings there. Take a look at who still holds the fastest lap. Still Zavi with that 121.1. Very good from him. Gap to leader now. As you can see, Skybits, MJs, and Cali have all been lapped at this point in the race. Gelmel now coming into the pits. Gap for Gelmel is currently at 117.4, and he has been lapped now as he's in the pits. He'll be looking to unlap himself, I'm sure, at some point in this race, as our race leaders have not pitted yet. Brownie and some idiot on the 17-lap-old hard compound tires. Couple of tight intervals are forming here. Cali taking over Gelmel there out of the pits. We'll have to take a look and see if there was any contact. It doesn't look like Gel had any front wing damage there, as it looked very, very, very tight from the Mercedes. Zavi in P10 now, currently less than a second separates him and the Toro Rosso counterpart ahead of him. Both these drivers running that Honda power unit. Zavi coming out of the DRS straight. Not close enough to make a move on the Toro, but it's very possible he will down the pit straight with the soft compound, or we could see it here now. Ooh, wheel-to-wheel action here coming through Sector 3. A little bit of a lunge there from the Toro ahead of the Red Bull coming through the last couple of turns here. Ooh, very, very tight there from the Red Bull driver as he almost clips the rear tires of that Toro, losing a little bit of time there. Ooh, a spin from the Toro Rosso. The Toro Rosso is off. He resets the track quickly, but it's not enough. Zavi now down the pit straight. Going into turn one, has definitely successfully taken a solid P9 position here in the race. We are on lap 19. He is on the soft compound, of course. Very unfortunate for the Toro Rosso there to have that spin. Not too sure what's going on, as his car is currently ghosted. Cali now, P12, very close to the rear of Gelmel. These two are battling. Cali now ahead of Gelmel coming through turn one. Turn two now. Wheel-to-wheel battle here coming up through turn three. Gel back out in front of that Mercedes. Very, very tight racing here between these two drivers in P11 and 12 at the moment. We'll play close attention to this battle moving through lap 19 now, as Cali still very, very tight to the rear of that Renault. What a battle coming through turn one. Cali off into the grass. He goes wide. He will not be happy about that. Fortunately for him, no damage to the wing. He'll look to make back up that time now on Gelmel in that Renault. Currently 6.5 seconds behind. Very interesting race here. A lot of different tire strategies. A lot of different pit stop strategies here, as we'll take a look at what's going on for stops. Skybits, unfortunately, having had to stop three times here in the race, he currently has the most stops on the grid. Gelmel, a close second with two stops so far. Everybody else here in the race on the one stopper. One thing to note is Brownie has stopped. Four fresh tires. He's now onto the medium compound. Tried to pull off an undercut here on some idiot. Some idiot still driving on those hard tires. He has got to be feeling the loss of grip at this point. We'll see if we see a pit from him here on lap 20. Absolutely crazy from him in the race lead. You can see he's a little bit all over there. He's struggling for grip now. Hopefully he doesn't have any issues coming through here. Very, very risky from the Racing Point driver running 19 laps on a hard compound tire here in Spain. Brownie, 26.6 seconds behind some idiot. We'll see if his undercut paid off. Obviously, he was very tight on the race leader throughout the majority of this race until he had an unfortunate spin a few laps ago. Very interested to see what comes out of the pit strategy here for that Williams. Some idiot, just not, he's just so comfortable on these hard compound tires. He's gone 20 laps now, looking like 21 on the hards, coming down through into turn one. This area, of course, has been a hot spot for drivers throughout the race to spin. We'll see if he's able to keep things clean through here in turn three. Looks like he does, coming into sector two now. Brownie coming across, setting the new fastest lap of the race, a 120.6 on the medium compound tires. I can't believe he hasn't pitted yet. I thought for sure he would have pitted at the end of lap 20, but here we are in lap 21, looking to stretch those 21 laps. A little bit of dirt there on the back of the Racing Point. Coming through into sector three now. This could be difficult with the tire wear. You can tell Brownie's already made up 3 seconds here on the medium compound. We'll see if that undercut pays off for the Williams. Could he be stretching these mediums to go on softs? We will find out in just a moment here, as we're going to stay glued to this driver to see what kind of tires he gets. On to the mediums he goes. And where is that Williams? Still coming around the last turn here. What kind of gap are we going to be looking at for the race leader? It's going to be close. Brownie gaining tons of time here. Brownie, of course, is going to have the hotter medium compound tires. Although they are 3 laps old, he should be able to make up a little bit of time here on that Racing Point. Very interesting to see what will happen in the race lead with those two. We'll check back in with them in a little bit. Not too many tight intervals at the moment. We'll have a look at where everybody stands overall. Some idiot in the race lead on the fresh mediums in that Racing Point. Brownie in P2 in the Williams. David in P3 in the Renault. Tech Slave in P4 with the Alpha. Smasha in P5 with the Ferrari. Bois P6 in the other Alpha. Flyer in P7 with the other Ferrari. Looking like a good finish for those Ferrari power units, of course. Travesty, another Ferrari powered unit in P8. Tesmo, P9 in that Honda powered Toro Rosso. Xavi behind him in the Red Bull in P10. Gelmel in P11 in the Renault. Cali P12 in that Mercedes, as we see an overtake here. Xavi coming ahead of Tesmo through into turn one down the pit straight. We'll see if Tesmo's able to make a move to take that position back. Doesn't look like it. Xavi on those fresh mediums, Tesmo on the older hard compound tires. Xavi is going to be much quicker than that driver for now. MJ's in 13th, Skybits in 14th. Skybits hopefully will get some kind of saving grace here in the race, maybe catch himself some points. Not having the race he wanted here in that Red Bull at all. Flyer now very, very tight to the rear of the Alfa Romeo. Flyer on the newer tires by 1 lap. Coming down into turn one here. Move down the inside from the Ferrari driver. A little bit of contact there. Ooh, very, very close for that Alpha. That could have gone either way for those drivers there. Flyer able to pull out the position. Now up into P6. Bois in that Alpha looking to make up some space here. Perhaps catch back that Ferrari. both Ferraris running 5 and 6 right now, looking to be a solid finish for the crew over in Maranello. Of course, the Sauber team, the Alfa is running 4 and 7 right now. It's an Alfa sandwich for those Ferraris. We'll see if Bois is able to come back and apply any pressure to Flyer here soon. Flyer on the faster tire right now than his teammate Smasher. We'll see if team orders come into play for those two later on down the line. Brownie now having fallen back 4.2 behind the race leader of Some Idiot. We'll take a look at who's been lapped so far here in the race. Looks like half the grid has been lapped as it's 14th all the way up into 9th positions have all been lapped so far by our race leaders. Gap from P8 to P1 is a full minute, 2.6. Xavi, Angel on the two-stopper, Sky on the three-stopper. Some Idiot crossing the line now with a 119.7. on the mediums. Take a look at the position changes here in the race so far. Some Idiot and Brownie have been deadlocked in that front row battle. David has moved up 2 positions, Techslave up 3, and Smasha up an impressive 5 positions. Flyer has been smack dab in 6th since the start of this race. Bois in P7 has moved up 4 positions. Travesty had started on P8 and he's still running in P8. Very consistent from the Haas driver. Xavi back 5 positions. Can't be too impressed with that. Of course, we saw a spin with him earlier in the race. Tesmo up 2 positions into P10. Gelmel up 6 positions, having started at the back of the grid. He's currently running in P11. Cali moving up 3 spots. He's in P... Ooh. Looks like we have an issue from the Mercedes once again as MJ's overtakes him into P12, up 4 positions. Cali up 2 positions from where he started in 15th. Skybits down a massive amount of positions here, 5 positions down for Skybits. He started in P9 in the Red Bull. Unfortunately, out of this race are the McLaren drivers of DS, who was looking very, very racy here early on. JBS in the Toro and Wakayo in the Racing Point, all out of this race here so far in Spain. As it's now Flyer on the rear of his teammate, less than a second separating Flyer and Smasher. Now we'll see if team orders come into play. Flyer looking very quick on the fresher compound hards. The grid has separated quite a bit here in Spain. No safety cars yet. We'll see if we see one in the next few laps here as tire wear starts to come into play and people are more prone to losing traction and spinning. We've seen a few spins here. Nothing to really talk about putting drivers out of the race. The biggest spin I can think about was, of course, from our P2 driver of Brownie when he was less than half a second behind the race leader. He spun the car and unfortunately lost a massive chunk of time. I do believe the gap grew to around 6.5 seconds after that. He has not been able to recover since in that Williams. Travesty into the pits now for the soft compound tires. We'll see if he's able to do something on those. As like I said earlier, he ran in P8 for pretty well the majority of this race. Now getting pushed back one place as he comes out of the pits here. Not too much of a gap separating him and the Red Bull though. Xavi taking a 5-second penalty for ignoring blue flags. Not going to be happy about that, I'm sure, is the Red Bull of Xavi. Flyer still on the rear of his teammate Smasher there. As we come through Sector 3 now, moving into the pit straight, we'll see if something happens here between these two Ferraris. Looks like the Ferrari moving down the inside of his teammate now with the DRS. Doesn't look like he's gaining too much speed on his teammate there, moving down into turn one. Very nice camera angle from Cody's here, as it looks like Flyer now up into P5 ahead of his teammate. Not too much of a battle there from Smasha as we come through turn three now, moving up into sector 2. Looks like he's made that move stick. Could be team orders. Could just be clean racing from the two Ferraris. Not too many tight gaps to be spoken of right now, as Brownie currently 5.5 seconds behind the race leader. Some idiot having a superb drive here in Barcelona so far. Currently six laps to go. If you've been following us for the majority of this race here, ASN has posted a link in the chat to vote for your driver of the day. Head on over to that link he posted in the chat to do that if you feel like it. Quite a few different drivers here showing what they're made of with some of the crazy overtakes we've seen so far here in the broadcast. David having run P3 for the majority of this race. Brownie in second for the entirety of the race, as well as some idiot in the race lead. Very nice driving from those three. Keep in mind, guys, this was a wet qualifier as well. So strategy definitely got wrenched for these guys when it came to qualifying. Now here on the dry race in Spain. Some idiot in that racing point very, very quick today. Skybits, very, very unfortunate race for him, starting in P9 back in 14th in that Red Bull. Of course, one thing to be aware of are penalties here in these races. Of course, when these drivers cross the line, there could be a bit of a shuffle with the penalties. We'll see if any of these drivers are able to make some moves here in the last few laps in the last phase of this race. Of course, now you got to see the tire life going to start to play a bit of a role here, as we have a few drivers on 16-lap-old hard tires. Of course, MJ's in that 12th-place McLaren, leading the pack on the 17-lap-old hards at the moment for tire life. Both our front runners on mediums now. They started on the hards. As we see Skybits coming out of the pits on the soft compound tire. Looks like he went in for some fresh tires. Maybe he'll be looking to set the fastest lap of the race. It's also possible he may have had wing damage there. So fresh wing, fresh tires, fresh pace, hopefully, for the Red Bull driver. He'll be looking to maybe set a fastest lap here in Spain to get some kind of points. MJ is now 18-lap-old hard tires. Other tire wear leaders are, of course, Smash, Techslave, and David. Not too many gaps right now on the grid. Not too much wheel-to-wheel action happening. Very fun race to commentate so far, as Travesty now. Looks like he's made a quick overtake there on Xavi. Not too sure what happened there. Didn't see a tight gap between those two drivers. Could be possible Xavi had a bit of a spin. MJ's on the 18-lap-old hards, currently 1.5. Ooh, even more as he overtakes Tesmo coming down the pit straight. Not too sure what happened to Tesmo here. Could be that he has damage. As we'll take a look on the front end coming down into turn one now. It looks like Tesmo, no damage on the Toro Rosso. Not too sure how the McLaren on the much older tires was able to overtake him so easily. That McLaren on an absolute charge here on lap 31. Keep an eye on Tesmo as he tries to take that place back on the 16-lap old hard compound. Hey, what's going on, BTF? Welcome to the stream. Sorry, Sneaky, I saw you early as well. Welcome to the stream, guys. Lap 32 now, second final lap of the race. Take a look at who's gonna be lapped here at the end of the race. Looks like Skybits unfortunately has been lapped twice. Very unfortunate showing for the Red Bull driver here, as Cali all the way up through into Travesty and P8 in that Haas have all been lapped here. Some idiot showing some very, very skilled driving here. Very, very intense first couple of phases here in Spain. Unfortunately, not too much action to speak of here has happened in the third phase of the race. As we now move on to the final lap here, some idiot down into turn one we go. Skybits retiring out of the session. Not too sure what happened to Sky there. This car is currently off in sector two. Don't see anything from the views of those drivers coming around there. It's possible he had a spin of some kind. Flyer 1.7 behind Tech Slave. Cali taking a 3-second time penalty now after multiple warnings. Like I said, guys, a lot of players taking penalties here throughout the race. We'll see if they play some kind of role coming through the final lap of the race. Some idiot shaping up to be our race winner here in Barcelona. It is, of course, round five, the Spanish Grand Prix for the ASN PCL League. Rounding the final turns now is the racing point of some idiot. And of course, some idiot coming home to win the Spanish Grand Prix for the ASN PCL League here. Brownie not too far behind him, looking to come second. Very nice drive from both of those two, holding on to their qualifying positions. Very, very intense battle early on in the race between the Williams and the Racing Point drivers, but unfortunately that Williams wasn't able to keep tight to the Racing Point due to a spin. Travesty coming in eighth now as he was lapped. Xavi finishing ninth behind him, as it's David looking to finish third here. David in that Renault crossing the line third here. MJ's finishing 10th in that McLaren. As we see penalties come through now. No penalties that I saw there. So it's actually some idiot first, guys. Brownie second, David third, Tech Slave fourth, Flyer up in fifth, Smasha, his teammate behind him, in sixth, Bois in seventh. And that concludes our race. I'll go over the grid one last time before we get out of the race lobby. Very interesting Spanish Grand Prix to watch, of course. Very interesting overtakes. Got to see a lot of that on stream, so I'm very thankful that I managed to catch that. So, our race winner, some idiot in the Racing Point, taking P1 from the United States of America. He started first. Brownie in second, and the Williams from Germany in second. David in the Renault third. Tech Slave in fourth. Flyer in fifth, Smasha in sixth, Bois in seventh, Travesty in eighth, Zavi in ninth, and MJ's in 10th in the McLaren. Those are your points finishers for the race. Tesmo in 11th, Gelmel in 12th, Cali finishing the race in 13th. Skybits finishes 14th, DS in 15th, JBS in 16th, and Wakayo in 17th. Those last four drivers from Skybits onward, unfortunately unable to finish the race here in Barcelona.